A numerical expressions, operations, and steps are found in its words that detail the process. Look at the grouping symbols to discover which calculations must be done before another. Let's see what I mean with a few examples, a few numerical expression samples. But first, a solo on the bongo.
Let's go!
What's 4 times the quotient of 20 and 10? Before we multiply, we need to find the quotient. We put brackets around 20 divided by 10. Get 4 times 2, 8 answers the question.
To write and interpret numerical expressions, we read them closely and ask these questions.
So 14 and 5, 14 minus 5 gets brackets, the difference is 9. The next step is symbolized by the division sign. Divide 90 by 9 and 10's the quotient we'll find. Let's see an example, one more time, with the best rhymes you're ever, ever, ever gonna find. But first, a solo on the bongo.
Let's go!
What's 10 times the sum of 40 and 53? First put 40 plus 53 in parentheses. The words tell us to add and get 90. Then multiply by 10 to end the verse.
To write and interpret numerical expressions, we read them closely and ask these questions. What operations are described in this problem? And what's the order in which we will solve them? Let's go!
When math class is in session, expression. Word clues can help us choose the operation so we can make the correct calculations. Plus, all together and all total and sum. These are our clue words for addition. How many more minus remain? Few with difference. Are all clue words for subtraction? By multiply times product of. Are all clue words for multiplication? How many times divide goes into quotient? Are all clue words for division?
To write and interpret numerical expressions, we read them closely and ask these questions. What operations are described in this problem? And what's the order in which we will solve them?
Visit numberock.com for exclusive content, lesson materials,